where we finally, yay, leave Mazatlán.
Yeah.
Make our way further south.
So I hope you guys like this episode. We'll see you at the end.
Yay.
Bye.
Is this a shower? No way. We have a shower?
It's a deck shower.
We have a deck shower. It works too. Doesn't have any hot water yet, but that's to come. We gotta plug in the heater element part of it. But we have a deck shower.
We have a deck shower.
Do you want a towel?
Did a few jobs already. We're just waiting on tropical depression. I guess it's tropical storm. Xavier to bug out further south of us, and then we're gonna bug out south. Yay! It's been a weird year for weather. Hurricanes, tropical storms, and I'm just gonna play with my engine, which is what I always do. It's an old guy thing. Yeah, that's what they call it. No, that's it right there. See, look. I am now going to attempt to install the remote control for the auto helm. Why do I want to do this? I'll show you. Here, come with me. Come here, way up here. It's like the friendly giant, except I'm not friendly and I'm not a giant.
So we come into this locker, and up in there, where's the screwdriver in? It's around here somewhere. There's a screwdriver sticking through, and oh god, crap. I don't know where it is, but I gotta find it, and then I gotta shove the wire in here and hook it up to that thing there. Oh, crap.
To get this shit show on the road. It's 8:10 in the morning. High tide is in 10 minutes. We're going over to the fuel dock. Just over there. Past Pull and By. And then we're going to head out to Stone Island and continue our journey south. Right?
Right.
Right.
And rock and stomp at Stone Island.
No, I don't think so. But that's what everybody tells us.
Right.
So, we are sitting at Marina Alicid at the fuel dock.
Right.
Yeah. We pumped fuel into one tank, and their system didn't record how much fuel was actually pumped into our tank.
So we pumped about 7 inches, which would probably be about 20 gallons. And their system read 0.5 liters.
Liters. So we're now waiting for a guy to come down and repair their system. It's high tide now at, was at 8:20, it's now 9:15. And we had wanted to go out with the high tide. It's a dropping tide, so we will wait. Don't know what's gonna happen or how long this is gonna take us, but we're stuck here till the guy can come and repair their system. And we can pay for our fuel. And we have one more tank to pump.
Yep. Plus gas.
Plus gas, which they're not pumping anything because their system
apparently
is not working.
Their meter system is all shot, so.
Since the fuel pump had no records of how much fuel we pumped into the first tank, we went back into my old log records because I keep track of how much fuel we put in each tank. And we determined that based on the number of inches that we had pumped into the first tank, that we had took on about 110 liters of fuel.
The manager at the El Cid agreed with our records, and once they got the pump fixed, we continued on. We were finally free to go. Or so we thought. What happens is we finally get out of the channel, start motoring away from Mazatlán, turn on the water maker to start making water and commission it, and it immediately fails, the membrane fails. So instead of getting water at 150 parts per million, we're getting water at 2,100 parts per million, that membrane had completely failed. So we turned around, headed back to Mazatlan, and licked our wounds, ordered a membrane. The next day, we take a walk down the beach from El Cid Marina to Looney Bean to have a nice lunch and console ourselves so we're not out cruising. And it's a beautiful day for a walk on the beach.
Yes. We're off! Finally left Mazatlan. Just to go over to Stone Island, and you can't hear me over the engine, so... Bye-bye, Mazatlan! Bye-bye, Mazatlan! Say bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Mazatlan! Bye-bye, Mazatlan! Anchored in Stone Island. We've already done... What did we do? Bad Moon Rising. Yep. Yep. No, we didn't record it. We're not that good yet. But we're just watching the sun go down behind Stone Island. Mazatlan. Oh, it's a pretty nice day. Tomorrow we get to drive all day and all night so we can get to Metigen further down the coast. Heading for Puerto Vallarta. But it's a pretty nice day. Very nice anchorage. And we're anchored here. I'll just pan really quickly over to... Oh, sorry for the camera swerving all around. We'll edit that part out. We're anchored here with our new friends on... What's it called?
C'est bon.
I don't know what it is with us and Big Benito's, but we attract them like bees to honey. Big Benito's like to hang out with our fat little girl. Anyways, they're going to Isabella tomorrow. So we'll part ways and then we'll meet them up again probably down the road in Altamba or Punta Mita or somewhere in Puerto Vallarta. Looks like a calm night. A calm night of serenading by my sweetie. Adventure buddies playing the guitar. She's working on a new song, so she's got to figure stuff out.
Down the way where the nights are gay and the sun shines daily on the mountain top, I took a trip on a sailing ship, and when I reached Jamaica, I made a stop. But I'm sad to say I'm on my way, won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around, I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town. Sounds of laughter everywhere and the dancing girls swaying to and fro. I must declare my heart is there, though I've been from Maine to Mexico. But I'm sad to say I'm on my way, won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around, I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town.
Just a little south of
the end of our first night watch this season. We left Mazatlan, actually Stone Island, yesterday morning at about 8 o'clock in the morning-ish. And we are coming into Matagin, which is another 12, 14 miles away, but I don't know, what time is it? 5:30 in the morning? It was a fairly uneventful passage. Weather was good. Looks cloudy when we get in here. They might get a little bit of rain. It is. National disaster, it rains in Mexico. Other than that, it was good. Jackie let me sleep all night, so I let her sleep for the whole morning. Now I'm just gonna wonder what I'm gonna have for breakfast.
Eggs and bacon when we get
eggs
anchor down.
Eggs and bacon when I get the anchor down at 9 o'clock.
Sunrise. Quite the interesting sky this morning. Got some scattered clouds. Heading into Matagin. Matagin. And out that way, the Puntinita and Banderas Bay. Where do I are now? Not that much farther. Probably another miles, maybe.
Thanks for watching, guys. We enjoyed making it.
We always enjoy making it.
We did.
We had a great motor sail down, as you saw in the episode. There's never any wind when we want to move.
Yep. But if you guys like these videos, please subscribe. We also like your comments, so please leave a comment and we'll answer them as the internet allows. And for our two patrons, thank you guys. Thanks for being our patrons.
Thanks for being our patrons. And if you want to become a patron, please go to patreon.com later than we think and become a patron. We would really appreciate your support. And all new patrons this season, first 10 will receive hand-painted t-shirts, male and female, depending on who you are. Or if you want the opposite sex one, that's fine
too. Hey, we're from Vancouver. We're cool with anything, man.
Yep. So please subscribe and your support is most welcome.
Bye. See you next episode.
See you next episode. We have a little baby gecko. Hi, baby gecko. He's just hanging out on the boat. You can eat all the bugs you want to eat. That's not a good place for you to hide. No, it's not. You get all squished in there. You get all squished in there. Oop, there you go. Now you're all brown. You were all white before. You were on the deck and you were all white. Now you turn brown. Baby gecko.